And then here's a tough one. It's the reason I got counseling to begin with. Responsibility. We need to accept responsibility to do what we can about our situation while surrendering to God all those things that we can't do that are beyond our power. But we must carry, the Bible says, carry your own load. And that's being responsible, not expecting someone to come in and magically and wonderfully fix everything for us. From New Life Ministries, this is Going Deeper with Stephen Arterburn. I'm Stephen Arterburn. And Going Deeper is all about taking the tough issues, the hard issues of life, looking a little bit deeper inside so that we can gain some insight into our lives. Hi, Steve Arterburn here, and thanks for joining me for Going Deeper, going a little bit deeper today into what do you do to make a crisis as good as it can get in the midst of the crisis. There are a lot of things that we could try to do, a lot of things that would fail if we did them. But let me just give you a few things that might help when you're in crisis. Imagine you have a fire in your house. The fire has engulfed all of your bedrooms and your kitchen. And you are in the living room arranging the pictures on the wall to be just perfect. Now, wouldn't that be foolish? Of course it would be foolish, because you're probably going to lose it all. Well, we see that is foolish. A lot of times our lives are being destroyed and we are doing things that are like the equivalent of arranging pictures in the living room. It's silly what we're doing, and we're not really facing how bad the problem is. Well, also, wouldn't it be silly if your house is engulfed in flames, finally got the living room there where you had been rearranging the pictures, and you had a little garden hose and you were out there trying to fight the fire? Silly or sad. Well, you need to do something if you are in a crisis like that. You need to get help. You call 911, you call the fire department, you get them to come out there as soon as possible to save whatever you can. And whatever reason you wouldn't call them, you better work through it. Oh, wow, I'm a clutterer. I don't want people to see how bad things are. Maybe that's why the fire started to begin with. So you have to work through that with somebody, or you have to say, I can't call the fire department. Would you call them for me? Whatever it is, we need to get some help. In times of crisis, when everything gets magnified in isolation, we need to get some help with other people. Second thing, I think it would be really helpful to change the way you start to think about things. Now, if you've been thinking, I've got to do this, I've got to handle it, well, you're wrong. We need help. Or it's too late to do anything. Well, that's wrong. It's never too late. Till we die, then it's a little late at that point. But you can do things. And if your thoughts are really crummy, you can start to change what you're thinking about. Like anything that, as it says in fourth chapter of Philippians, anything that's true and pure and right and good, let's think on these things. And you know, if you're in a relationship, you start thinking on these things, you start sharing those things, and it actually builds the relationship. So we might need to look at a change of thinking. We go from a change of perspective that, oh, I need to do this on my own, to a change of thinking to the positive, to the good things, not the negative. And then here's a tough one. It's the reason I got counseling to begin with. Responsibility. We need to accept responsibility to do what we can about our situation while surrendering to God all those things that we can't do that are beyond our power. But we must carry, the Bible says, carry your own load. And that's being responsible, not expecting someone to come in and magically and wonderfully fix everything for us. And then gratitude. What do you have to be grateful for? I think it's a great idea to keep a journal of things that you need to be grateful for, or that you can be grateful for. That could change everything. Then you look back, look at this, got that, I got this blessing. And they start to add up, and they really do help you in dealing with all the stuff you're facing because you know there's some good stuff that you're thankful for. And then I would just say seek serenity or seek contentment in Christ. Let me read you the full serenity prayer. I just think it's fantastic. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things that I can't change. So I come to a place in my heart, my mind, where I truly am going to stop fighting, going to stop pulling, controlling, and say, okay, I can't change these things. And I have the serenity to accept that. And then I have the courage to change whatever I can. And then I've got this wisdom. I'm asking for wisdom to know the difference. And then it goes on. Living one day at a time, enjoying one moment at a time, accepting hardship as the pathway to peace. Isn't that amazing? You know, I'm not going to be at peace waiting for everything to be peaceful. I'm going to go through hardship, and as I accept it, I can do it. And then taking, as Jesus did, this sinful world as it is, not as I would have it, and trusting that you will make all things right if I surrender to your will, so that I might be reasonably happy in this life, supremely happy with you forever in the next. That's the full serenity prayer. So there is a reasonable happiness that if I don't have it, it's there for me. I just have to go and get it. And it really does begin with asking God to give you help, humility, and hope that leads you to reach out to some other people. Now, I would just encourage you to call 1-800-NEW-LIFE. And if you're struggling with something, find a life recovery group where you can go and participate and see how this 12-step life recovery program can play out in your own life and lead you to a place where you truly can be content in the worst of circumstances. Anybody can be content sitting on a rainbow. Well, maybe not, because you're worried you're going to fall. But anyway, the point is, there are a lot of things that we can do, a lot of situations we can be in where we feel happy, content. But I'm telling you, the person that thrives, that succeeds, that moves on, finds some way to not be miserable when everything around them is a source of misery. That's really the key. Hope that's helpful to you. If you need any help kind of putting all this together, or if you want a copy of 6 tips to finding contentment in a crisis, you call us at 1-800-NEW-LIFE. I'll see you next time. Thank you for joining me for Going Deeper. I hope something I've said may have helped just a little bit. If you have a question you'd like me to answer or comment, just email me at stevesocial@newlife.com. I'll see you next time.
If you want to support Going Deeper with Stephen Arterburn, be sure to subscribe so you never miss another episode. And if you know someone who would benefit from this episode, be sure to share it with them. See you on the next Going Deeper with Stephen Arterburn from New Life Ministries.